You see, I don't really have a savings account, and I learned that lesson a couple days ago while searching for a place to live. So I just sold my desktop computer to start that savings account. And the thing is, I thought I had a savings account. I've been coasting along fine with the amount of money that I've had in my bank account for a while. You know, I actually keep a pretty tight eye on my expenses by tracking them every single month. So I know exactly how much has been in the bank in the past, and it served me well up until yesterday when I calculated the expenses it was going to take for monthly rent, utilities, and the security deposit. I was going to have to last 2 weeks with only $200 in the bank account. That's not a safety net. That's not a savings account, okay? So I just want to go through, you know, what I've done so far that have helped me keep a very good eye on my expenses, as well as what's going to happen in the future to avoid me having to live off of $200 over the next 2 weeks.
I mean, it makes sense, right? In order for you to know where you want to put your money, you have to know where you have been putting your money. Imagine walking around every day not knowing where your money's going. You're like, man, you know, I have $2,000 in the bank. Man, like, feels good. I'm like on top of the world. And then over the month and over the weeks, slowly that starts to dwindle down. You're like, where did I put that? Like, where is it going? Where could it have possibly gone? I just had $2,000. A lot of people don't start a budget until they have to. And that was my case back in mid-2019. When I looked through and realized how much money I was spending on fast food, I'm like, oh, a trip here, a trip there. It was like $300 a month in food. Same thing with subscriptions. I had like $100 in subscriptions I didn't even know I had. It was like I knew I had them, but I didn't really stop to think, like, did I really need those subscriptions? You know, Hulu, Spotify, YouTube, stuff like that. I cut all of those because I wanted to take as much money as I could and put it into investments, such as, you guessed it, Bitcoin. It just blows my mind how keeping track of where you've spent your money will influence what you're going to spend your money on. After you understand the categories of expenses that you have, you start to understand how much it costs to be you. Once you understand how much it costs to be you, you can start to project, you know, what do I want my life to look like? You know, what areas would I like to spend more in? What areas would I like to spend less in? Then you can multiply that and understand how much in your dream life, in your dream world, how much would your dream life actually cost? I have my number. I'm not quite ready to share it because I think it's surprisingly lower than most people realize. Your dream life costs a lot less than you realize. Now, I understand the context, okay? I'm talking about to have $200 in the bank for 2 weeks. What gives me the right to, you know, talk to you about finances? These are my findings, okay? I'm just repeating what I've learned by reading things on the internet. I'm implementing as much of this as I can. However, I'm not exactly speaking from experience because I'm not living my dream life quite yet. I mean, life is good. It's all a matter of perspective and blah, blah, blah and stuff like that, but I think you understand me. So what should someone do to avoid having to live off of $200 for 2 weeks? Well, I'm not gonna be in that position. I found a cheaper place than I originally intended. I just sold my computer for $300. So now I got, you know, I have more money. That's not gonna be enough for savings. I'm looking at, you know, 3 months of expenses in the bank account. So I'm going to just simply save that money up as much as I can until I have that safety net that's like comfortable. If my car breaks down, if my computer breaks down, stuff like that. Those are the things that make me think, you know, $200 in a week is not good. If either of those things happen, like, I'm screwed, it's over. Meaning I'd have to sell Bitcoin and I would cry. I would cry. Not really, but maybe. So that's kind of today's lesson, is track your expenses, know where your money's going, and project where you want your money to go in the future. How much does your dream life cost? How much does your life cost now? You should know those two numbers and you should be working towards that dream number. The whole reason people spend their time working is so that they can spend their time as if money didn't exist in the first place. They want to be freed from the 9-to-5. And unfortunately, most people don't get there. So you have to come with a tactical plan and be able to execute on it. I'm just getting hyped up. And the reason I'm getting hyped up is because I just launched a website where you can buy any one of the posters that I've been doing for the last 281 days. $22 out the door, this thing's yours. 11 by 17. I'm just gonna show you a couple of my favorite, dude. Favorable Moon. The colors on this thing, dude, this was taken in Weberville. All right, if you're a Webervillian, that might be the one for you. Next up we have, dude, the colors on this one. Shift Change. You got the orangish moon, the yellowish moon. just a beautiful hue of pink and purple in the middle. I mean, it's more of a darker vibe, yet it's still colorful, you know? Then, of course, we have the beautifulest sunset. Dude, the colors on this thing. This is gonna brighten up your room, okay? You're gonna be like, you're gonna be walking into your room, you're gonna think, I didn't know the sun was setting, it's noon. You're like, oh, it's just a poster. It's just a poster, man. Fooled once again with that beauty. And then if you want a darker vibe, well, this is the last one I'm gonna show you. Again, any poster on my profile is available. You'll have to DM me. I'm slowly adding posters to the website, www.ezrawithacamera.com, same as my username. However, if you want a poster, just reach out, $22 to your door, free shipping. This one is Through the Brush, you know, name's pretty self-explanatory. It's the moon through the brush, all right? This is another beauty. That's all I got for you today, a little lesson and a little action to that lesson, okay? If you want to support the dream, if you want to support the dream of a dude living out of his coworker's bedroom, you can do it for only $22 a poster. All right, that's actually all I have for you. I'll see you tomorrow.